Hello all, welcome to Sean's Cuisine. Today I want to share with everybody is how to cook the Ribbentrop. Okay, the Ribbentrop actually I go to my local supermarket. It's a donut store in Nest, dekat Nest ini je, around 3 km from my house. So my catch today is I not get catch in a fishmonger, yeah. I get the catch in a supermarket, okay. So my catch of the day today is a trout fish, okay. Alright, this I get a trout fish is a Ribbentrop fillet, is for two. It costs around €3.98, okay. Okay, I have two fish here. I have two fresh trout fish here. See that? Okay, from this is fresh. It's a Irish farm. Okay. The ingredient for the Ribbentrop trout, actually I have two pieces trout fish. See that? Two pieces of fish. I'm going to cut it the tongue. And here I have baby spinach. See that? Baby spinach. And also I have the stem broccoli. I have here is baby carrot. Okay. And also I have a lemon. Okay. And here you can see is I have a potato already boiled. This one already cooked for already 30 minutes. It's soft now. Okay. And here I have some chopped garlic, chopped onion. Hello, Mama. And here is I have butter, Irish butter. Here you go. For mashed potato, I have a cream. Okay. And I have here is capers. I have a capers in the jar. Alright. Salt, and of course I have for vegetable is a spray for the greasy oil. Okay, it's for vegetable. Okay, the first thing is I want to show you the trout we have to cut half. Okay, this fish is fresh, already fillet. Okay, I dah buang dia punya kepala. Okay, dah fillet, jadi dia ketul macam ni. Okay, so I got if anybody see me just my live video just now in live, I go to supermarket, so I got this fish. This is my catch of the day. Okay, and of course, I need some of chicken stock. It's not much. Okay. Okay, now let's start. Okay, the first thing is the trout. I have to cut half. Cut half trout. That the fish trout already cut half, so I got 4 pieces. Okay, I think for 2 plates, but I got only for 1 plate anyway. So here is mashed potato, is nearly ready. I double check. A bit more. Alright. Okay, now let's cook it. Okay, now the first thing is I have to make the butter sauce. Okay, the butter sauce, of course, we need butter, we need some cream, okay, and also we have, I have capers here, I have some chopped onion and chopped garlic, okay, then can I get more cream, it's okay, and I have some, here is chicken stock. Okay, let's put in, first, a little bit of oil. You can use olive oil if you have. Okay. Okay, the first thing for the sauce, we have to put the onion and garlic saute. Okay, when you saute onion and garlic, make sure it's pan not too hot, yeah. Okay, because we just want the sweat, the onion and garlic, okay, actually. Like this. Okay. It is very home cooking style, yeah. In the restaurant, normally they put white wine here. Okay, but I don't use a white wine here. Can put the capers, maybe around, I must say around 1 tablespoon capers. We saute again. A little bit of chicken stock. Okay, again, for a lot of people thinking when you use a fish or seafood, people thinking why never use of we never use a fish stock or seafood stock. But normally it's my experience in our cooking in the chef in the 5-star hotel. Normally for the fish we use a chicken stock. Okay, you know why? Because otherwise it tastes too strong. Okay. Alright, now continue that. Now we have to heat the pan. Okay, now we want to cook the trout. Yeah. Okay, I hope this pan is not thick. It's a little bit old pan. Okay. I have, so I'm going to sure get a new one by next week, hopefully. Okay, we do the small reduction. We do small reduction like this. Is for get a taste. Is onion and capers. Okay. Okay. Okay, the for mashed potato, the cream, we have to heat. We have to put in a microwave, maybe for a few minutes. Maybe, okay, maybe one minute less. This fish, you can use salmon as well. Okay, but actually I can get salmon just now, but I already cooked a salmon last week. So to this week, I can use a sea trout, okay? A rainbow trout like this. Okay, it's cheap. It's a two fillet. It's around €3.50, something like that. Okay, now, fish. When you heat the cook the fish, okay, make sure pan is not too hot, medium heat, okay? And it is petua, yeah? Because if you scared, your pan going to be stick. You have to put some sea salt here. Okay, put the sea salt first. Put the sea salt in the pan. So that we seal the fish. Okay. Seal the fish. And low temperature. Okay. Right. At the same time, I have to check the potato. Is it ready? Yep, potato is ready. Now I just put the water in the paper. Okay, when you make the mashed potato, after you boil the potato, you need the rest, the potato at least for 5 minutes. Okay, you know why? To make a potato rest like this, okay? Right? Okay, now the fish is ready, very lucky. like. Okay, when you cook the fish, this restaurant style, yeah? Okay, when you cook the fish, only for one side, like this. You never turn the fish. You know why? Because bila you masak ikan, you letak satu side. Lepas tu you turn to another one more side. So you you compact, you press the meat ikan tu. You akan press dia punya daging ikan tu, so dia ikan tu akan jadi liat. So dia masak slow macam ni, only for one side, yeah. Not turn. This turn maybe take for few second only, okay? Alright, now you see the reduction just now here. Okay, now we have to put the butter. Let's put the cream first of all. Let's put cream. Okay, make the reduction here. Alright, see the sauce. And we start to put the butter, okay? No use of flour. Butter, yes, sister. Api perlahan, otherwise butter will be split. Dia akan pecah minyak butter tu. Okay, perlahan je. Okay. Ah, okay, you see the fish? It's ready cooked. So, I have to turn off. Turn off api ya. Okay. Now, I have to do the mashed potato. For mashed potato, we need a hot cream. Okay. Okay. Is it the spinach? The spinach you don't need to blanch. Okay, this is a raw spinach. You have to put here. Alright, you put together with the mashed potato. Just now you need to blanch the spinach. You know what spinach? Bila you letak kat sini potato panas, automatic spinach bakal masak gitu, okay? Now we mash. Okay, sudah. Cream here, and then put some butter. The butter you don't need to heat hot them, okay? Letak butter sejuk is room temperature macam ni. Sebab apa? Butter kalau ya, kita pakai butter yang mahal, okay? Kita pakai butter yang mahal, suddenly kita panaskan butter dengan cream, so butter tu akan split, so no point you use a very good quality butter, okay? And then, see? Okay, chunky mashed potato. Alright, now after seasoning the sauce. Alright. This is that mashed potato. Spinach mashed potato. See? Must be like this. Then I turn off. See the sauce for the fish is ready now. Okay. Off. Ready to go. The spinach mashed potato also ready to go. Okay, I put here. So now is vegetable. I'm going to put the carrot first. Okay. Here you have a hot water and also you have the salt in there already seasoning. Okay, for the sauce, see the sauce? I have to put some lime a little bit. Okay, you continue cooking. See, the sauce already consistent. Mashed potato is ready there. Alright. And also the fish. See the fish? I cook only half, okay? So now, okay, slow. Kita masak ikan tu slow. Tapi dalam masa yang sama, ikan tu dah masak. Nampak? So we basting the fish like this. This is restaurant cooking, kan? Yeah? It's restaurant cooking, we do like this. Okay? Okay, basting the fish. Okay. Taking off the sauce. Now. Nah, bila kita basting the fish macam ni, okay, ikan tu akan masak. Sebab apa? Sebab your sauce is hot. Sorry, your butter, your cooking oil here panas. So kalau you masak ikan macam ni, I'm sure your fish not going to be overcooked. Okay, I'm sure. Okay, because sebab apa? You boleh nampak ikan tu masak ke tak. You boleh tekan dengan tangan you. Tapi kalau you masak ikan one side, after you turn another side, so you cannot feel that. So now you can see the fish. See that? This is a petul, yeah. Okay, now it's vegetable. Bang in there. Okay. Now I just clean up this bit. Sauce. Nampak tak sauce? Pekat. Consistent. See this? Nice potato ready. Check the taste. Nice potato. Yeah. It's a little bit more soft. Yeah. Potato ready, fish ready. So now I'm going to show you the plating. Okay. Enough meat. And the table ready. So now. For the vegetable, I don't like saute. I like this. Okay, vegetable. Okay, tutup dia, angkat dia, bubur dalam bowl. Macam ni. Okay, see that? Jangan lupa put in the bowl. Macam ni. Okay. And then, this is a room temperature butter, ya. Boom. Okay. And kita bowl dia. Bowl dia. You know what? Yes. Then sizzling the salt. See that? It's fresh. You see? You know why? Kalau sayur, you saute dengan butter, so butter tu dah pecah minyak. So no point we use a very good quality butter. You know what? Sebab butter tu dah pecah minyak, so dia punya fat tu dah tak ada hole. It's no hole in the vegetable. You see that? See the butter is not split. Okay? It's the way you have to cook. Okay? And now plating. The plate. Ni. Okay, the butter sauce. Okay. Boom. Yeah. Here. Now. Okay, now the mashed potato must be cold, keras macam ni. Okay, it's not creamy mash. See that? It's like this, okay? It's like here. Alright. And then, we have to put the vegetable first. This is a home style cooking, ya. Yeah. The presentation also same like home as well. Okay. More. Carrot. Okay. And then the fish. I turn the fish. See the fish. Must be crispy skin. See that? Crispy. The skin must be crispy. You cook only for one side. It's a medium heat temperature, yeah? Now. fish. Two fish, ulat, and then the sauce. Okay, the sauce, up to you. Some of the people don't want to put on top of the fish, or you can put on the side. If you like me, I like put on the side. Because why? Because the ikan tu cantik kan. Bila ikan cantik, you letak sauce habis. So dia tak enak ikan. Voila. So now, more. Ready? So I can to use the seasoning of grapeseed oil lah. I can to pour. Pass it a bit. Now ready. Okay, pan fried rainbow trout, spinach mashed potato, fresh garden vegetable. I use broccoli, baby carrot, and also I use lemon butter sauce. This is Kepa's lemon butter sauce. Okay, this is look like. Okay. Okay, I going to put all my recipe here in my YouTube channel, so everybody can follow me in my YouTube channel is Sean's Cuisine. Okay, I'm going to write down the recipe, how many gram we need. Okay, bye. Selamat mencuba. Okay, then please don't forget subscribe me in my YouTube channel.